Early signing day festivities. Football legend Lou Holtz once said, "I can't believe that God put us on this earth to be ordinary." When he uttered those words, he must have had Kenton Kirkland and Jamari Whitehead in mind. Institution. To Kenton and Jamari, we are proud of you, and tonight we celebrate you as you take your next step into brighter future. You will forever and always be Ichiban number one. Now we will have Principal Hall come forward with a few words.
Tonight is such a great night just to watch these two young men be honored here. I say this all the time, and I'm going to continue to say it. You know, tonight is a night where athleticism marries academics and the opportunity it provides. Because what some of you may not know was that both of these young men have a 3.5 GPA or higher. And that is to be commended. That's the opportunity tonight because of the academics, not just athleticism, but the academics as well. I'm so very honored because I spent 15 years of my career at First Coast High School. I was a teacher there, I was an assistant principal there, and for 2 years I was a principal. In that 15-year stint, I had the opportunity to be the assistant principal slash dean of two of these people on stage tonight, Mr. Whitehead, who frequented my office, and Ms. Johnson. Well, she was Ms. Johnson at the time, but Ms. Whitehead. And to be able to be the principal of their son now, Mr. Jamari Whitehead, it is such an honor to be here to see the fruits of my labors twice over. Also, it is such a privilege just to be an alumnus of Rains, as they soon will become. One, to become an alumnus as soon as a couple of days, as he will be entering the Florida State University, one of the only universities on earth. And I am so proud of this young man, Mr. Kenton Kirkland, for going to make history here at Florida State University. Not one of the easiest universities to get into, but it's going to go there and do well academically as well as athletically. So tonight, I'm going to give them a great round of applause. We applaud the students as well as our parents. I'd like to also give a round of applause to our head coach and other coaches of football, as tonight we're honoring football players. So, a great round of applause for Coach Donovan Maslin, as well as his football staff, for working with these students, believing in them, and ensure that they are here tonight. And if there are any teachers and counselors, we applaud them because, again, without academics, they wouldn't be here tonight. So a round of applause for them. And I want to go ahead and be selfish and give a round of applause for me, just to make it certain that I still need these guys. Just kidding about that. But congratulations to both families here tonight in honoring your hard work and your labor of love for your students. So tonight, congratulations to Kenton and Jamar. Congratulations.
Madeline, to the podium. Coach.
Head coach here. This is my third year. I've been here since 2012 as a 22-year-old. And just staying true to it and just believing in the process. And, you know, in 2020 was my first year as a head coach here. It was during COVID, so it was really tough and nice on any coach. But like I tell people all the time, I wish that any coach would, you know, their first head coaching job, I wish they would have a coach as well. Because it really makes you stronger mentally to really have to grow up real quick. So my first year was KJ's going into his sophomore season. And we had a conversation with mom, dad, and himself about a transition to move to the opposite side of the football. And I told him, you know, the size of the draft, the length that you have, you can stay in front of the receiver for, you know, about 4 seconds. I'm pretty sure, you know, you're going to get what you desire. He didn't give me the back talk. It was, yes, sir. What do I need to do? And they, you know, dad put a, and mom put a well-organized plan together to make sure on their end they were doing what they needed to do. And, you know, we were doing what we needed to do on our end. And it just showed the hard work, the dedication that he has, determination, you know, athleticism, but more so like as a person, as a kid, you don't find too many kids that come to school and, you know, get 3.5 GPAs and, you know, also every day showing up, working out 3 times a day, you know, twice with us. You know, in summertime, he would work at 5 in the morning, and then come at 8, you know, at workouts. But, you know, a lot of people don't see, you know, that type of work, but they just see this right here. So, you know, to any student athletes that's out there, man, just continue to work, put your head down, don't worry about, you know, if you're gonna have offers, don't worry about if you're gonna get in school. Just make sure that if you're working hard enough, and you believe, and you have faith in God, and you have faith in yourself that you can be able to do it, you're gonna go out and do it. So he stayed true to it, you know, did track as well. You know, we have our funny conversations. I always talk to him about, you know, what college would be like. You know, we went on a visit to Florida State one time. You know, I took some of the coach's staff with me. They were playing with Ford. And, you know, his head was kept on left and right every time. And I was like, man, just stay focused. And, that's what comes to make sure, you know, you keep your eyes on the prize about what you're supposed to do, your task. But to my coaches, I appreciate you for both, you know, just all athletes that we come across, just the time, the dedication away from your family, to dedicate to these young men day in and day out. We know you're doing a lot of other stuff. You know, thank you to not robbing to come out and be a part of this special program that we have here. But, Junior, I appreciate you. I love you. I wish you the best. And I'm a Florida Gator fan. But I will be wearing some thought in the goals.
Thank God.
Oh, and then Mrs. Kirkland, I want to thank you for trusting me and my staff with Kenton for these 4 years. It's been very, very interesting and very fun. I remember, you know, the long message I got sitting in my office, you know, about what you wanted to do over the summertime. And, you know, usually, you know, it's kind of unorthodox, you know, to do stuff like that, but I just had to sit back and just trust, you know, let parents do what parents need to do. And you see that it was in the best interest that he was part of that particular team. Because after that moment, it's really took off. So I appreciate you for, you know, your knowledge, your insight, and your trust. And I love you guys. So hopefully you guys stay around and help out with the touchdown club.
Before I start, thank you all for coming out and celebrating this moment with my teammate and I. I know y'all have better things to do, and we have better things y'all could be doing instead of watching the signs of those pieces of paper. However, the fact that y'all did take this time out every day means that y'all understand that this isn't just a piece of paper that we're signing. Over the past year, I've been preparing for this moment right here, a moment that's going to determine the course of the rest of my life. Some people look at it like it's the next place I'll be going to school. Others look at it like it's the next place I'll be playing football. And while they're not completely wrong, they're not completely right either. It's going to determine who I'm going to be surrounded by for the next 3 to 5 years and who's going to pour into me and the man I'm trying to become. As you all can imagine, this isn't a decision that should be rushed or considered easy. So I want to thank this university for making this choice seem like a no-brainer. This program is the one that not only makes sure its athletes are physically at their best, they're a program that makes sure their athletes are mentally, emotionally, and spiritually at their best as well. I'm extremely blessed and grateful for the opportunities offered by other institutions, but there is no school that felt like the stars aligned the way they did here. This school makes me feel like I'm wanted for not only the athlete I am, but most importantly for the man I can be. They plan on investing in me with everything they have, and they better know that I plan on giving them no less. Furthermore, I thank all of the college coaches who have reached out during this recruiting process. I thank my teachers and mentors for pouring their knowledge into me. My coaches for bringing the beast out of me that I didn't know existed. My older sisters for being my first role models, my big supporters, my ride or die, and my best friend. My parents for loving me enough to give me every chance or opportunity I needed to develop and showcase my talents in every aspect of my life. Neither of you stopped investing in Kendall, Cotton, or myself, and I'll always be grateful for that. Last but definitely not least, I want to thank God Almighty. None of this would be possible if I didn't operate his strength and wisdom and wasn't blessed with his favor. With that being said, after careful consideration, speaking with my family, and a whole lot of prayer, I decided that I would be continuing my career as a student athlete at the Florida State University. Go Noles.
getting married, and at the reception, his mom was sitting there, and I did not have a clue who she was. And, you know, she was just vibrant, energetic, you know, just fun to be around. So, Jamari ended up getting hurt one game in his temporary season, and she brought him up so he could ride with us over to, I believe, it was Orange Park, you know, it was the game after that. And she got out of the car, and I was like, that's kind of funny that a small word that, you know, this young lady that we were sitting with is the mother of Jamari. And, they, you know, it kind of showed, like, the person that he, you know, that he is. And then, in 2020, also, when I first took over, I got a text message after, I believe it was, like, the Red and Gray game. And it was from his dad. And, you know, he was at the Red and Gray game, and he was impressed about what he saw, you know, that we were doing. And he wanted to make sure that his son was a part of it. So he made the decision to transfer over from first coach, doing his sophomore season.
Last coach.
I would say usually it was one of the best decisions that he could have ever made. Knowing the work that we put in, you know, in the off season and the summertime, you know, the mentality that the coaches have, it really rubbed off on him. And, you know, and his mindset and his tenacity really rubbed off on us as coaches and the players as well. You know, a lot of the players when our program looked up to these two young men, the leadership, the guidance, to be able to make, you know, plays on the field to be a role model inside the school as well. But Jamari came over, you know, I believe, you know, at the previous school they wanted him to play in the secondary or something like that. And we all knew Jamari was not, you know, going to be a safety or anything like that. But, you know, the work that he put in the summertime, it really changed his body to get to the size that he is now. It really went unnoticed by a lot of people. You know, working out over the summertime with, you know, Josh Allen here and there. You know, 5 a.m. workouts, just like him. And then coming to 8 o'clock workouts with us. And, you know, we just don't be passing. You know, Dad was at summer workouts, so he understands what we put our kids through, and he's seen it firsthand. And to be able to handle both of those in one day, to recover, and, you know, to do it again the next day, really shows the dedication that he has, and also where he really wants to go. I was amazed at, you know, his this season. We knew he was going to have a great season, because we really wanted him to play, you know, the middle position, the middle linebacker position. But, you know, we needed some extra rush on the defensive end. And, you know, he didn't give any revolving people, yes, sir. Whatever I need to do to make sure that the team is successful and have a great season, I'm willing to do. So he led the whole, you know, led the team with 13 and a half sacks this year. Give to the kids during the summertime what we expect. You guys exceeded, you met and exceeded our expectations, and we just can't be so much more happy for what you're doing now, what you're going to be doing in the future, and because you have brothers and sisters that's going to be looking up to you. You know, I believe they will be, you know, with you as well. And it's great for them to see that, so they can strive to work towards, you know, a goal that you have for our season goals. Mom, Dad, I appreciate you for trusting me as well, you know, with my coaching staff. to be able to work with Jamar, you know, for these past years. It's very fun. You know, he's a character that people don't know about. But, you know, we've had some funny moments, you know, some great questions that he asked, you know, some heated moments in practice. You know, had to tell him kind of chill back in the day, you know, stay the O-line for the weekend. But I personally, I just appreciate, you know, you guys for trusting us, trusting the administration, trusting the athletes, everything that's important for your children. And I appreciate you guys.
First and foremost, I would like to thank God for waking me up every morning and putting me in this position. I would like to thank my family, my support system, friends, and trainers that have always been there for me. I would like to thank my mom and my dad for pushing me to do the best man possible, loving me with all their heart, and raising me the right way. Also, I would like to thank Coach Mass, Coach Butler, Coach Tuck, Coach Seaver, Coach C, and the rest of the coach. The rest of the coaches that are being developed to the football player I am today. Attending race has given me a great foundation, not only as a football player, but as a man and a student as well. Rains and the bonds that I have created will always have a special place in my heart. I would like to thank all the college coaches that have reached out to me during this recruiting process. That being said, for the next 3 to 4 years, I'll be attending the University of Georgia Southern.
Media people like to speak with the two honorees that we let them do their thing first. And then once that is done, y'all can come up and we can pick all the pictures we like in front of the backdrop. We have refreshments in the back, we'll cover the music, but we'll let our gentlemen that are here representing the various media outlets speak with our honorees and their families first.
All right, very quick, brother, the decorations were done by Ms. Borkum, secretary here at Brayton High School. She is the owner of the Dunn Event Center on Dunn Avenue. So we want to thank her for her actions. She's such an amazing job. And lastly, the NCAA, a couple years ago, you know, put in early signing periods so that, you know, young men like, you know, these two up here can sign early and have the possibility of enrolling into school early to get a head start on